So today I'm talking about a P0405 code, what it is and how you go about fixing it. And so what is a P0405 code? Well, it's an exhaust gas recirculation sensor A circuit low. And so what does this mean? Well, basically vehicles have what's called an EGR valve, and that's taking exhaust gases and feeding them back up into the engine. And when these exhaust gases get fed back into the cylinders, it lowers the combustion temperature, which is going to reduce emissions. And depending on the vehicle, the year, the make, model, different things like this, there can be differences inside of these systems. Some vehicles are controlled by vacuum, and some are electronically controlled and different things like this. But basically, the way this is working is that exhaust gases are going to go up to the EGR valve, which is being controlled by the computer. And the computer is going to open or shut this EGR valve to let exhaust gases go back up into the intake, which is then going to go into the engine, lower the combustion temperature, which is going to help to reduce emissions. But when you get a P0405 code, the computer is seeing some kind of problem with this EGR valve. And so it's going to have to be troubleshooted to know why. And so what would be some possible causes of a P0405 code? Well, the first thing that could cause is that EGR valve has just gone bad. It just needs to be replaced. Depending on your EGR valve, how it's controlled, if it's controlled by vacuum or if it's electronically controlled and things like this, there's some different methods to go about testing it. There's some good YouTube videos on that. A very common problem with these EGR valves is that they become all clogged up from the exhaust gases that keep flowing through it. They can become all clogged up, and that's going to cause issues. For this reason, a lot of people, they'll take it off, they'll take it apart. They'll clean it all up real good. They'll put it back on, clear the code, and see if the code comes back. And quite often, this does work. But keep in mind, it could have also failed. It could have also just gone bad. So the first thing on the list is going to be a bad EGR valve. The next thing on the list is going to be that there's a bad sensor. And this is going to be like a bad differential pressure sensor or a bad manifold absolute pressure or something like that. Again, it's going to vary. It's going to depend on the vehicle, the year, the make, the model, to know which sensors the computer is using for the EGR valve for your vehicle. So you will have to do a little bit of research to find out which sensors are doing what. There can also be a sensor located inside of the EGR valve called the EGR position sensor. But again, this can all vary. So it's going to be a good idea to get a diagram for your specific vehicle to know for sure what's going on with your EGR valve system. One thing to mention is that if one of these sensors does go bad, like the DPFE sensor or a MAP sensor, usually you're going to get another code. For example, if you also got like a P0107 code, manifold absolute pressure, barometric pressure sensor, circuit low, then it's a good idea to go check out that MAP sensor and be sure that it's good. Or another example would be like a P1197 code. If you also got this code, differential pressure sensor, intake manifold, high input, then it's a good idea to go check out that DPFE sensor and be sure that it's working, because the next thing that could cause this is a bad sensor. And the last thing on the list is going to be that there's some kind of wiring issue going on, like an open, there's a short, something along these lines. So you can go and get schematics or a diagram for your particular vehicle and a multimeter and check to be sure that you're getting the right voltages, you got good grounds and different things like this. Quite often you can find these schematics or diagram for vehicles using Google, like Google Images or something like that, and you can get them for free. But sometimes they can be hard to find, you can't locate them. If you do need them and you can't find them for free, I'll put some links down below in the description for some good paid options, but hopefully you can find them for free. But the last thing on the list is going to be a wiring issue. And so that's basically it. I just wanted to give a basic overview of how you go about fixing a vehicle with the P0405 code. If you have anything to add, please comment down below. If you have any questions, ask me and I'll try to answer them. If this video helps you, please click like, please click subscribe, and have a good day.